What is a punishment?
If you do something, if you, I don't know, if you punish someone for a bad behaviour, maybe hit them, I don't know.
No, what is punishment? The concept of punishment.
Or something like
the
that.
Concept. Punishment. What does it mean?
What do you mean by it?
I'm asking
and I'll tell you whether I agree or not. Hmm?
No, punishment is some kind of putting something on a people that you otherwise would not want to have it yourself, right? It's kind some kind of suffering.
That's a
punitive measure that is taking something from you or inflicting some harm on you or inflicting some pain on you.
Yeah.
You know, this is what it is.
Yeah.
Putting someone in a prison is devoiding them of their pleasures of the life outside and the freedom. So you're taking their freedom away is a huge punishment.
Yes, I do agree.
It's
but I think punishment for me kind of means that you, if you punish someone, I don't know why, it's just semantics.
But do you agree anyway?
It kind of implies that you
let's use as a concept in
punishment,
okay.
Right?
Okay. But do you agree in general?
We agree, yeah.
In general,
I
no problem.
I would say
right.
If you put someone in jail,
so if a child, does bullying all the time, constantly in school, by hitting someone, you know, even say someone he dying gross physical damage, GBH, to other children, constantly.
Yeah.
Now, disciplining the child should be acceptable, right?
Yeah. It doesn't mean that we have to beat the child.
Why do you go into beating? We're talking about discipline.
No, I agree. Yeah, of course, we need to do
now,
something.
Now, disciplining can have several forms.
Yeah.
In the punitive measure. It can even be physical beating with a stick, if necessary.
I don't really agree, because I don't think this is going to do any good.
Hmm?
I don't think this is going to do any good. And if you look at, like, different paradigms in psychology and how people learn effectively, beating children up is not one of the effective methods to achieve that.
So, are you saying when the child gets a slap, the child doesn't learn from it?
It does learn from it, it certainly does,
so it
but it also takes a little damage from it.
What damage?
Psychological damage.
No, what is that damage?
Damage.
No, what is that damage? I'm sure many people have had some of these slaps when they're young, right?
Yeah.
From their parents.
Yeah.
So what damage has it done to them? Occasional disciplining?
Physiological harm and emotional
such
harm.
Such
as pain? For example?
At any moment, if you punish anyone, even putting them in a prison with a satellite TV is still a punishment. It causes them physiological, psychological harm. Let's talk about psychological harm.
Yeah.
So you don't necessarily disagree with psychological harm. You're saying it's okay.
So, in order to protect other people.
Yeah. So
I guess it's a continuum, right?
So when you want to protect other children, when you want to protect other children in school, if, for example, I'm not saying I agree with it, but I'm just arguing in principle. If the teacher decides to, you know, give it a stick or a beating with a stick like this, whatever.
There's a reason why this is illegal in this country.
Please. I'm just wondering. So are you saying the child will have such a psychological trauma that they will need some kind of rehabilitation later?
That they will what?
That the child will suffer from such a psychological trauma that then we have to put them in mental institutions and have all this kind of
rehabilitation.
Right. So if that
they might.
So if that measure was painful to the child and it worked and they didn't have a long-term suffering, why are you objecting to it?
What if there was another way to achieve the same goal but without harming the child?
No, that's not my question though. You can find alternatives.
That's my question to
but
you now.
My question is, if that was an alternative which doesn't cause this problem later on, then in principle
then you would be in favour for this alternative, right?
So in principle, what I'm saying is, discipline in that form, in principle, you would not disagree.
No, I don't disagree with protecting other members of society from harm if certain people have a mental problem or anything.
Okay.
I do not disagree with that, but we've established that already. I just say we should choose the method that causes the least amount of suffering to the individual we are disciplining.
Okay, let's talk about murder, which is very gross, right?
Yeah.
Punishment for a murder, I'm going to give you several options to see how this will work in a society and the best way to protect the safety of the public. Yeah. One murder is £10 fine. Or
that's not much.
Or I'm giving several options.
Yeah.
Put them behind bars for 12 years. Or in return, get them killed through capital punishment. Let's take these three examples.
Yeah.
Which will be more effective in the sense of protecting the public?
From this one person?
Not from crime of murder and the punishment associated with murder in societies.
Yeah.
In societies.
Interesting question. Right. Let me answer that. I think what you're going to do, if you go with capital punishment, right, you are going to scare people off murder. People who really want to murder someone, who are really emotional about a certain topic and they just lose their shit, they are still going to murder. They won't care about it. But everyone else will be living in fear. Right? So you actually only...
Not being a criminal, that means
they deserve
only
being
by
killed.
Having this law, you are actually going to create
about life
some unnecessary suffering.
To be killed.
Because
that's not suffering.
People do not really trust the system then, I guess.
That's not
right?
suffering at all. Are you saying...
What if you could be charged with capital punishment and you didn't actually murder someone?
Can you carry on again?
That's exactly what can happen if you have capital punishment.
Carry on. So you've given an example of... If you have capital punishment as a punishment for murder, that creates unnecessary suffering to people who want to commit murder.
Not to people who want to commit murder, no, but to society, to the public as a whole.
No. Public safety is about not being murdered by other individuals.
Yeah, and I don't think that capital punishment is the right way to protect people from murder.
Let's understand something like this. So you have, the crime is murdering someone, taking life away.
Yeah.
The deterrent is if you take someone's life away, your life will be taken in return. Are you saying...
And can I make my point?
Because three examples, we're going to go all these options.
Yeah, yeah.
So the wannabe killer and a murderer says, that's unnecessary suffering. Are you being sympathetic to the wannabe criminal, or are you being sympathetic to the public who wants to be safe from the criminal?
I wouldn't want to go ahead and kill the murderer.
No, we're not talking about killing yet.
Yeah, you said...
The very, very concept of punishing someone with £10 fine, 12 years in prison, or capital punishment.
Yeah.
So you started with capital punishment. If capital punishment somehow creates fear within individuals who are wannabe killers, are you...
Not who wannabe killers. Not individuals who wannabe killers. That's not what I said.
Okay.
But people who might fear being accused of murder even though they didn't actually murder anyone.
No, we're not talking about this mistrial.
But this is what you will have. You will have some people who are innocent and who will be convicted.
Just because you have...
That is what is going to happen. And I don't think anyone should have the right to say, we are going to take another individual's life.
I think you're taking it very lightly.
We are
not saying...
This is what capital punishment is all about.
No, but you missed the whole point, I think.
Okay.
When you have a system of crime and punishment, we are not advocating a crime and punishment where based on suspicion only. It has to be absolutely as much as possible, beyond reasonable.
As much as possible.
Listen.
What does that mean? And who says it's actually beyond?
Must be
please,
proven.
Please, brother, one moment. Beyond. Yeah,
how?
Beyond reasonable punishment. Okay.
Yeah. What is proof? What is sufficient proof?
Oh, one
you know who and who decides it?
Please.
You know, we just run into trouble.
Beyond reasonable doubt. If there's any doubt...
And who defines that? A judge,
Can I?
A human being.
Look, I'm offering you a particular worldview of crime and punishment from Islam.
Yeah.
In Islam, if there's any doubt, capital punishment cannot be implemented. Then the punishment will be discretionary based on the judge, according to his understanding of the situation.
Yeah. Yeah.
So that means it's a very just kind of system, where any uncertainty, you cannot implement capital punishment.
Do you understand that there is nothing in the world that we can know for sure?
Yeah, right.
Sorry?
There is only probability.
Even that statement.
Anything for sure. You cannot even say that this tree is
even
standing
that
there.
Even that statement
of yours.
We don't
know. We are all kind of victims.
Did you just hear what he said?
Psychology and how our brain processes.
Did you just hear what you just said? Even that statement, your own statement, you cannot be sure it's true.
Of course I never said anything.
Then I can ignore that safely.
No, bye.
I don't have to deal with it.
No, you don't have to ignore it.
No.
These
please. When you said we can
I just say that you can't
please.
Be absolutely certain that I want to
show you where the problem starts in the statement like this in a concept.
Yeah.
You cannot be absolutely sure of anything, including your own statement.
Yeah.
That means the statement which says you cannot be sure of anything is disputable because you can't be sure of that.
I can't be sure of anything, but I'm willing to admit it.
Please listen.
And I think this is
it's important to
acknowledge this.
I would like you to reflect on what you just said.
Yeah.
If you cannot be absolutely sure of even your own statement to be true or not, then you cannot just say, this gentleman says, yes, we can be sure of something. Because for you, you cannot just take that away from him. Because why? In your worldview, your own statement, your own paradigm, your own belief that you cannot be sure of anything includes your own statement itself.
I've never said that I am sure of what I say.
So when
I'm
you said,
to learn,
so,
and
so,
if you have a good point,
so when you
I'm
say,
to consider it.
So when you
and
say,
I think that's very
okay.
important, then
so
I think we
statement.
All should do that.
No.
And that's not a bad thing.
No,
that's
statement,
not,
that statement,
yeah?
Is it true or false?
Which?
Your statement that we cannot be sure of anything. Is it true or false?
It is most likely true.
No, you cannot be sure of anything you say.
No, it's probabilities.
No.
It's probabilities. It's not 50-50.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. So
it's
now, so now,
50-50. I can say I'm like 99.999% sure that there is a tree. Okay?
So now,
I might be hallucinating.
So now we have come to realization that
miscarriages of justice happen.
So what you've realized, what you've
make mistakes.
Of course.
No, no.
Yeah, that's my point.
So what
I don't think anyone
so what you are operating
to take someone else's life because mistakes are going to be
look,
made.
What
I'm not in favor of capital punishment. That's my
excuse
point.
Excuse me. Now you're actually going backtracking. You were saying
we started this discussion talking about unnecessary suffering,
please,
right?
You're backtracking.
I say I oppose unnecessary suffering.
No, why are you backtracking?
I think we should alleviate suffering if
okay.
we can.
I want to finish.
That's why I'm vegan.
Okay.
Now you start all this debate about capital punishment.
I want
that's
to.
Not really what I want to talk about.
Sorry.
You know?
I want to finish this point. We'll talk about veganism. If you're interested in talking about veganism, no problem. So when you said it's all about probability, so you don't have a problem with a judge using the older probabilistic method of ascertaining the truth of the reality. You have no problem with that.
Yeah, but not killing people.
Yeah, but not making the decision to actually kill someone on the basis of this.
Judges make mistakes.
Why are you saying that we are okay to make probabilistic judgment for everything else apart from this?
I don't say anyone should have the right to say we should kill another person. It's as simple as that.
What about killing?
What is so hard about this?
Okay. What about, what about killing other creation?
I don't think we should kill any living creature.
Have you ever taken antibiotics?
Yes, I have to.
And how many bacteria have you killed willingly?
Bacteria? I can make the case that bacteria are not sentient.
Excuse me. Did you talk about sentient? Or do you talk about living? You said living. So
I'm
now
sentient.
The
okay,
goalpost.
I've got to correct myself. This is not what I'm talking about. I think
we should not
harm sentient beings.
Excuse me. What's the difference between sentient and other living creation?
One's a
sentient
and the other.
Why one is okay to kill and not the other?
Why is it okay to throw a stone into the ocean, but it's not okay to throw your child into the ocean and then they drown?
Ocean as a water without any life is no life. But
it's not about the ocean, it's about the stone
versus your child. We're talking about life. You have two lives, bacteria and say human beings.
It's not about life.
Excuse me.
Bacteria are not sentient.
So why is bacteria okay to kill when they're alive?
Because bacteria are not sentient. They don't feel pain.
What?
They don't have subjective experience.
Is a cat sentient?
Yes, a cat is sentient.
Is a cat is sentient?
A cat has a central nervous system like we do, like
what
all
about trees?
Vertebrates
what
do
about
and
trees?
Many invertebrates.
What about
do.
Trees?
We don't have any reason to believe that trees are sentient. Trees do not have a central nervous system.
Can they feel
pain? They don't
pain?
Have the physiological
can they
capacity.
Feel pain?
No, most likely they can't.
What does science say?
The science says trees can't feel pain. We don't have any reason to believe
they react.
They can.
They react.
They react. So, yeah, but they don't respond.
No, excuse me. They do respond. So now this is where the vegans
They have intelligence, but they don't have sentience.
They have intelligence.
Yes.
So now explain that to me. How do you have intelligence without a nervous system?
Have you ever thought about what a computer does?
Hmm?
Computers?
Computers just programs. Computers are only programs.
And they're very intelligent, right?
No, computers are not intelligent. They're only programs.
Yes, they are.
No,
they are.
Computers.
That's like a basic definition of intelligence.
Computers are only.
Process data. No.
They're only following their programs. They're not intelligent. They're only following the programs. No.
This is the definition of intelligence. It's how we process information. How much is.
Can you ask a computer.
What kind of operations we can do?
So
and we do it mentally using our brains, and computers do it with their software and hardware.
Can the computer will not to follow the program willy-nilly?
Come again?
Can the computer program have their own ways of not following the program?
Not yet, no. Not
right.
Yet. We're not yet there.
So it's nothing to do with intelligence then. Intelligence implies what? No.
Yes.
What it implies is what? Some programs they're following that we have put through our intelligence.
Yeah, but still there
so
is...
So it doesn't make computers intelligent.
What you just say is that computers are not aware, right? They are not aware of their operations. They're not aware of what they are calculating, of the information they are processing. They just do whatever they're supposed to do.
So
it's the same with plants.
Does a bacteria feel any pain?
It's a very good analogy.
Okay.
It's actually the same
Excuse
with
me.
Plants.
Let's go back to the living things.
Yeah.
Does a bacteria feel pain, and are you certain about that it does or it doesn't?
I'm like 99.999% certain that a bacteria can't.
And how did you become certain?
Feel pain.
How did you become certain? 99%?
Because I'm quite familiar with some scientific studies when it comes to the nervous system, especially of vertebrates, especially humans.
So an amoeba doesn't feel any pain because it doesn't have a nervous system.
I don't think so. I'm not an expert in amoebas, but this is not the point. I mean, it's about we're not talking about bacteria. We don't even have to talk about insects. I mean,
so if you have,
do you think a cow is conscious? A cow is sentient. A cow can feel pain.
So you're saying the cow cannot feel pain, is that what you're saying?
No, that's not what I'm saying. I'm asking you what
no,
do you think.
I would like you to answer that question as a vegan.
No,
does a cow
I
feel pain?
I ask you a question now,
excuse
okay?
me?
So now
may
it's
I,
your turn
no, no.
to answer my
may, question. May I know from a vegan? May I know from a vegan?
A long time
no,
now.
May I know from a vegan, how does a cow feel pain? Is it because they have a nervous system?
How do you feel pain?
Hmm?
How could I know that you feel pain?
So if I have no nervous system...
If you want to go into the philosophy of
one moment.
I mean,
so,
come on.
So if I have a problem physiologically that I cannot experience pain, you can just kill me, right?
Not necessarily, but this is an interesting
one.
But that's not where we don't have to talk about this.
No, no, it's important. So if you have human beings who cannot feel any pain because of the pain receptors are not there.
They don't have the capacity to suffer at all.
So we can kill them.
Just
like we can kill the bacteria.
Listen, I think we could make an argument to say it would be okay to kill a human being if they can't suffer at all. However, I think it would have very bad consequences on other human beings. Other human beings.
Why is it okay to kill them? A person who's intelligent.
Listen.
Why is it okay
human
to kill?
Beings might still love this person. They might be emotionally attached to this person. And it might cause disruptions in society. If anyone thinks, hey, okay, I don't know, if people think I can't experience anything, they are just going to kill me. I mean, I don't want to live in a world where people go around and kill each other because they think you can't feel pain. So that's why
so
I
your argument,
the case.
To understand your case.
Morally, it would probably be okay. But because we can't be sure, we should give any human and any other sentient or apparently sentient creature the benefit of the doubt and say probably they can feel pain and we shouldn't kill them then.
Okay, so your argument of killing human beings, loving, caring human beings just because they cannot experience any pain is okay. That's
it's
what you said.
No.
As a vegan, you're saying.
No. No.
Let me ask you again.
No, do not make
no. Let me ask. Let me ask you again.
It's not okay.
Let me ask you again.
I think it's not the best thing we could do
again.
In society.
Let me ask you again.
Yep.
You can kill living beings which cannot feel pain. That's your argument.
Like bacteria.
Like bacteria, like tree. If you have a human being who cannot experience any pain, they're like bacteria in a tree, right? You can kill them because your argument of killing a tree, even though the tree grows, develops, tree has offsprings and so on, and I'm sure there's a lot of things between the tree and the offspring which you don't perhaps know yet. So,
which I don't know, which is probably not there.
But you're saying, I cannot kill, look, bacteria live in a colony.
Yeah.
Do you know that?
Yeah.
So they know how to form societies. They live in colonies. They have some kind of understanding
where they should
live together. So you have these.
If you want to call it that, yeah.
That's what it is. That's why we call them colonies. So now you're seeing these beings.
Yeah.
They live together, but it's okay to kill them because they don't suffer any pain because they have no nervous system.
Anyway,
let me finish.
Let's see other.
Can I finish?
Okay.
So you have a human being, many human beings, who somehow they cannot. They're fully well otherwise.
Yeah.
Fully well.
Yeah.